Hi everybody, this is Alex, and welcome to Enrich LA's Garden Lesson. Today we're going to be talking about parts of a plant. Today we're going to be learning about the different parts of the plant, many of which are edible. Did you know that over 390,000 species of plants exist, and only about half are edible? So today we're going to start with talking about the roots. Now the roots are the part of the plant that grows in the soil. And last week we talked about what soil was made of. Remember? Sand, silt, and clay. From the soil, plant roots are able to get water and nutrients that are needed for the plants to grow. Similar to how humans need vitamins and minerals to grow, plants also need nutrients to grow big and healthy. All roots are not the same, and some are edible. For example, look at this radish here and this onion. These are called root vegetables because we are eating the root part of the plant. Can you think of any of your favorite meals or snacks that contain any root vegetables? Write them down in your notebook. So next we're going to talk about the stem. Now the stem is the part of the plant that grows above the soil, and it's the main stalk of the plant. The stem is a transportation system. It actually moves water and nutrients up and down the plant. Kind of like a highway goes back and forth. The stem is also responsible for keeping the plant upright and not falling over on the ground. Vegetables such as asparagus, celery, kohlrabi, leeks, and this chard here all have edible stems that we can enjoy. So the next part we'll talk about are the leaves. Now, the leaves are super important because this is where photosynthesis takes place. Photosynthesis is the process when the plant uses sunlight, carbon dioxide that's in the air, and water from the soil to make sugar and oxygen. The sugar, also called glucose, becomes food for the plant. Leaves are usually green because they have a pigment called chlorophyll. Chlorophyll helps the plant with photosynthesis. There are a lot of leaves that humans like to eat, such as lettuce, cabbage, kale, and this beautiful Swiss chard. Can you think of any leafy vegetable that you like to eat? Most plants produce flowers, which are important for reproduction. Through the process of pollination, flowers create seeds, which then grow into new plants. A lot of the time, we eat flowers before they bloom, so we don't even think of them as flowers. For example, do you all like broccoli? Well, did you know that each little green bud that is in the end of the broccoli is actually a flower? Crazy, huh? If broccoli was allowed to continue growing, the little buds would actually bloom into yellow flowers. There are other flowers that we eat, such as nasturtium flowers, like this one, and also pansies and borage. So fruit is the next part of the plant that we'll talk about, and I'm sure you're really familiar with fruit. Fruit is the ripened ovary of the flower, and it usually is very pulpy and sweet. Now, fruit always has seeds inside. Fruits are usually pulpy because the plant wants animals to eat the fruit and then disperse the seeds. Some fruits that I'm sure you all love include tomatoes, cucumber, apples, oranges, and sweet peppers. Remember, if it has seeds inside, then it's a fruit. Well, what about the strawberry? It has the seeds on the outside. I'm going to challenge you to look that up and find out exactly what a strawberry is. So the last part of the plant we're going to talk about are the seeds. Now the seeds are usually produced in the flowers of the plant or are held inside the fruit. So all plants start their lives as seeds. Now, with the right conditions, sunlight, water, air, they grow up into big, beautiful, lush plants. Some examples of seeds that we eat include sunflower seeds, beans, peas, wheat, and corn. Did you know that each corn kernel is actually one seed? So let's do a fun activity that helps us learn about the different parts of the plant. For this activity, you're going to need a piece of paper, a metal spoon, a pencil, a shovel, and some markers or crayons. So you're also going to need a plant. So let's go out into the garden and find one. So we're out here in the garden and we're looking for a plant. I'd like to suggest you find just a typical weed like this dandelion. So if you can't find a plant that has a flower attached, that's okay. We can always draw one later. So once you've found your weed or your plant, take your shovel and try to dig out the entire plant, okay? So we want to get the roots. So I'm holding it by the stem and being careful to get all the roots. Ah, there we go. All right, so we have our plant, and you want to shake off some of that soil. Okay, and let's bring it over to our table. So the first step is to take your piece of paper and fold it in half. Okay, right at the crease of the paper, place your plant inside. There it is. Now fold the paper over your plant like this. Okay, now we're ready to go. Take your spoon and gently start to press your plant onto the paper. So this is a plant rubbing. So you're just actually rubbing the plant onto your paper. Let's get the flower in there. Alrighty, let's see what we have. Let's open it up. So you can see the soil and some green pigment on the paper. Remember what that green pigment was? The chlorophyll? The chlorophyll is what tells you that the plant is actually doing its job. It is photosynthesizing. Let's keep rubbing. There, got a nice print happening. Let's see what's going on over here. So do you see the green? So you can actually take some of the green leaves and squish them together to get more of the chlorophyll out and use it to further decorate your plant rubbing. So So let's label our plant rubbing. Remember what this was? Our roots. This part right here is called the stem. These here that are colored with our chlorophyll pigment are called the leaves. And up here is our flower. Now, do you remember what the flower makes? Hope you said seeds. Our plant doesn't actually produce any fruit, but if your plant did produce fruit, you can actually just draw them in. And label those. Fruit. Now, wasn't that fun? I hope you learned all the parts of the plant and how we eat all these various parts of the plant. Now, during your next meal, maybe you can think about what part of the plant you're eating. Roots, stem, leaves, maybe even seeds. And thank you for joining us in this garden lesson. I hope you and your families are staying safe. Until next time, we'll see you.